Nikola Jokic is one of the more skilled centers in the NBA. He has it all in his arsenal, and he has risen as a player from an afterthought to an NBA star. What I mean by an afterthought is that he was taken in the second round of the 2014 NBA draft. He worked his way up, and currently, I believe he is the best center in the league. A 7-footer with passing skills like Jokic is extremely rare, and in a way, he has changed how we view centers nowadays. Usually, it would rely on the point guard to do the playmaking, but Jokic is so skilled that he operates as a point center for his team. It's actually quite remarkable. Before I start this video, if you like the video, feel free to subscribe, comment, and give a like on the video. It really helps in boosting this content out to more people. I do more breakdowns like these on other players around the league. With that being said, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and don't forget to subscribe. Nikola Jokic leads the Denver Nuggets in points, rebounds, and assists. He is the Denver Nuggets at this point, and he has brought this team back into being relevant again. He is easily the most unselfish star in the league right now. And to be honest, he has the capability to go out and average around 25 points a night, but he doesn't look to do that. He is a team player. This year, he is averaging 20.2 points, 10.2 rebounds, and 7 assists on 52% from the field, 31% from 3, and 81% from the free throw line. He has an overall true shooting percentage of 60%, which ranks 8th in the league. He has had multiple triple-double games, and he is basically a walking triple-double. He isn't the most athletic guy, and he honestly looks like he plays with no care in the world, in complete cruise control, and still dominates each game. His offense, he can stretch the floor and bang down low with you. What I really like and appreciate is his post-game, which sadly is dying in the NBA, and to be honest, I'd much rather watch a good post-move than a crossover. Jokic has just found a way to be dominant there with an excellent footwork. His two-point percentage is at 60% on the season. A lot of his shots comes from the restricted area in the paint and the mid-range. In the restricted area, he is shooting it at basically 70%. In the paint, he shoots it at 60%, and in the mid-range, he shoots it at 44%. Efficient shooting when taking two-pointers. In the post, he is very annoying to guard because Jokic is extremely strong as a player, 253 pounds, can basically move any player in the league, and he has a variety of moves he uses. Fakes, jump hooks, fadeaways. He also is good at just isolating against the defender and sinking a jump shot. He uses a lot of pump fakes to fool his defenders to get to his spots. Defenders are at his mercy in the post, and Jokic is able to make his situation better by drawing fouls in post situations. What I've noticed in clutch time situations where he is very good at, he utilizes the post a lot, and he capitalizes and wins a lot of games with this. He is also able to create for his team. When the focus is on him, he draws a lot of double teams. He is so good as a passer that he can locate an open teammate for an easy bucket. He is really good as a pick and roll man, and since a lot of times once he catches the ball off the pick and roll, the defense collapses on him. He is able to find an open teammate or cutter to the rim. He also has a good handle on the ball. There has been many plays, even though it's quite slow, he shows off his handle getting by defenses and scoring. As a big man, his ball handling is the best I've seen from that position. Now, Jokic as a three-point shooter hasn't been shooting it the best from there the past couple of seasons, but he's able to stretch the floor and hit it here and there, 31% this season from there. He attempts around 3.5 three-pointers a game and only makes around one. He knocked down 71 threes this season out of 226 attempts. I don't expect him to be launching a whole bunch of threes, but the fact he can hit at least around two a game is enough, especially when a lot of his offense is centered around him in the post and creating offense for his team. He attempts majority of his three-pointers in catch-and-shoot situations, and he is knocking it down at 32%. He rarely attempts three-pointers off the dribble, and when he does, he shoots it at 31%. He shoots majority of his threes above the break, where he shoots it at 30%. He rarely attempts any threes from the corners. The left corner, he shoots it at 60%, and right corner, he shoots it at 40%. He took 5 three-pointers each from there this season, so it's not much to go off of. He has to work a bit more in knocking these down consistently when he gets the opportunities, and could probably look to increase how many he takes a game. Probably trying to take at least 5 a game at least is the best for him. Majority of the times he is open when taking these shots, just gotta get that percentage up. One thing that isn't mentioned a lot when bringing up Jokic as a player is how clutch he is. When the Nuggets need something in the clutch, Nikola always delivers. Easily the most clutch center in the league and arguably the entire league. His game elevates even more in crunch time. Jokic is also a very good rebounder. He uses a lot of his strength, and his ability to box out effectively helps him grab down more rebounds. Can grab offensive rebounds too and put himself in position to put back a shot as well. He does get beat by guys who are much more athletic than him, but overall he is good at getting in position to grab those boards. Jokic, overall, the best way to describe him is an all-around team player. He does the necessary things and makes the moves to keep his team competing. This is best shown with his playmaking ability. As I already stated, he has a good feel of working in the post and getting it to his teammates when he gets double-teamed. He has a great eye in spotting cutters, and he hits these guys right on the money. He's a center that makes his team better. I can't stress that enough. He elevates his team, and there honestly isn't a center in the league that elevates his teammates at an elite level like Jokic. He can even get flashy with some of these passes that he does. He has a good feel of what pass to use in different types of situations. There is concern of his turnovers. He averages 3.1 on the season, and sometimes that's just coming off of bad passes or forcing something that isn't there. With him being the tallest guy on the court, he really helps with locating and giving accurate passes to his teammates. Cutters benefit a lot of the times from Jokic. And this is why I truly believe the post game really isn't dead, but just evolved. Jokic is living proof of that. With him being so dominant in the post, defenses lock onto him a lot. And with his passing ability, he gets to pass it out to three-point shooters and cutters. He plays the post effectively. When the Nuggets need a bucket, why not go to the post where it's so easy for him to score there? Just overall, so much good action from his passing ability. His utilization of bounce passes, overhead passes, behind the back passes. Nikola is only 25 now, but he will definitely go down as one of the greatest passing big men in the game. Now, Jokic defensively, I can say, is pretty average. He is solid on the defensive end. He isn't going to protect the rim, blocking shots as your usual center would, but he plays defense a little bit differently. He does get burned when he plays one-on-one defense on a guard. He does have the physical tools that can help him shut down possessions, and he does hold his own well against other centers. You're just not going to be seeing Jokic guard other positions effectively. Just doesn't move well in closing out on players, or moves well laterally. What he really is good at on the defensive end is his ability to pick off and get a good amount of steals. He does have active hands, which allows him to disrupt plays and deflect a lot of passes. He is also a very good help defender, and because how big in stature he is, he's able to cover a lot of ground. At times, he is able to help on a possession while still being positioned to recover back to his original man. Help defense is at times a sin, but Jokic makes it work. He doesn't block a lot of shots, as I stated before, but he is good as a team defensive player. He makes the reads and has active hands to that to contribute to his defense. This makes up a lot for his lack of shot blocking ability. As I said before, he is good at holding his own against other centers and making them work with his strength. But when guarding faster, craftier players, mostly guards, this is where he struggles at. A cause for concern was Jokic's body. How well does he hold up overall in games? We have just seen a photo surfacing online of a much more slimmer Jokic, and it seems he is taking care of his body much like better. He looks like a different player. But we need to see more games before I can say that there has been any improvements or regression in his game because of this. Jokic is definitely the best modern day big man today, and a top 10 player in the league. We haven't seen an NBA center win the Most Valuable Player award in so long, and honestly, the chances of a center winning it is very slim, but Jokic has the best chance out of all centers to win the MVP in the future. He is still growing as a player, and he is the Nuggets' clear star. I don't know how far realistically he can lead the Nuggets, and don't get it twisted, that isn't his fault. I don't see a clear secondary option to help Jokic right now. Yes, there is Jamal Murray, and he has the potential to be a bright star in the future, but he has been inconsistent as a player right now. At this point, it seems like he is best suited as a third option on this team. The Nuggets have to find that second option, whether Murray improves to that or they find another player that complements what this team needs. Until they do that, I don't see this team going as far as the second round. The reason why Jokic is the best center in the league right now, to sum everything up, is because he elevates his team, not just him. So his team is winning games with Jokic as the first option, and this is without a clear secondary piece. So imagine when Jamal comes together and they add one more piece on this team. The Nuggets can be a first seed for years to come. Jokic is 25 years old and already has been named to an All-NBA first team and a two-time All-Star. He still hasn't even hit his prime yet. So we are going to see a lot of beautiful team play from the Joker.